Let's go ahead and do a practice prism sweep. So remember, the key thing is that normally you make sure that your prism is held over your plot center, and you turn yourself and you keep your prism right at plot center. Okay? I can't quite do that with the camera since I have to hold it in front of the camera, and I'm just gonna pivot the camera rather than having to constantly move it around. But just remember that normally you put the prism right over plot center and you turn around it. It's also important to make sure that you don't double count any trees, so you need to remember where you started. A good way to do this is just quickly pull out your compass, find the tree that's north of you, and start with that tree. So we're gonna start with this western red cedar here and sweep around clockwise to figure out which trees are in and which are out. So let's look, and this is a little tricky because you can see there's another tree behind it that kind of blends in, but let's, okay. So that tree is definitely in, so there's one. Okay, those trees are all too far shifted, so they're all out. Let's see, this one's a little tricky, but it's definitely, yep, those trees are getting shifted over too far. How about this one? That one looks like it might have a chance. Nope. Those trees are all out. That one's a little tricky because there's two stems there, or it splits a little bit, but I think it splits above breast height, so we're gonna treat it as one tree. So that one's in, so two trees are in. Those trees are all out. How about this Douglas fir in front of us? Okay, again, it's a little tricky, but there's the start of the shifted image and there's the actual image. They're definitely overlapping. So that Douglas fir is in, so that's three trees that are in. Okay, how about this western red cedar? That's in, that's four trees. And it's important to keep looking in the background too, because it's possible every now and then that you'll have a monster tree in the background that will be very far away but still in. So don't get blinders on and just look at trees that are within, say, 10 meters of you. I think I lost count, but I think we had four in so far. That's about right. Okay. Now this is tricky. These are ones that are overlapping, but they're overlapping with different trees. So they're not in. Let's see, and that one back there, it's hard for you to see on the camera, but that's actually two different trees. Right here is two different trees, kind of one behind the other. So those are definitely out. Let's keep going. Okay, this one's a little tricky. This is two trees kind of growing. It's a little hard to see them. So that second one, the one that's on the right, I'm gonna say is in, and the one that's on the left with the coarser bark, I'm going to say is out. So that's, I think, five trees in. Since I'm talking to you, I'm losing count. So if I've misspoken, you know what the right number of trees are. Okay, that's a pretty decent sized cedar. That's close, relatively close to us. Okay, that one's definitely in. So that's six trees in. And let's look at this cedar here. Seven. Okay. And we go back. And this was the tree we started on, so I'm not going to double count that. So, assuming that I counted right and didn't make any mistakes, we had seven trees that are in, and I'm using a prism with a basal area factor of 10. So, what is my basal area? What do I estimate my basal area is for this stand based on this plot here? And what are the units? My basal area factor, or BAF, or BAF, is 10 on this prism. So we multiply the number of trees, 7, times the BAF, 10, equals 70. And this is a metric prism, so the units are square meters per hectare. So we're assuming, or we're estimating, that the basal area in the forest, at least right around here, is 70 square meters per hectare. We are estimating that in this location here, we have about 70 square meters per hectare of total basal area. And if I had been interested in breaking this down by species, which is usually a good thing to do, I would have noted which trees were which species. And actually, I think I can look real quick. I think we had one Douglas fir, and all the other trees in this particular spot were Western red cedar. So if we have one Douglas fir times a basal area factor of 10, so we're estimating that there's 10 square meters per basal area of Douglas fir. Sorry, 10 square meters per hectare of basal area of Douglas fir. And then we had six Western red cedars, so we'd estimate 60 square meters per hectare of basal area of Western red cedar.